Hey again, everybody. My name is Jared Allison with JDA Florida Homes. I am a real estate agent with Century 21 Alton Clark here in the state of Florida. And in today's video, we're going to be talking about interest rates. Now, the feds are planning on 3 rate hikes this year for 2022, and I am here to show you what those forecasts look like. Before I get started, if you don't mind, go ahead and hit that subscribe button down below. It does help me build my YouTube channel and continue to put out more videos like this one. All right, so first off, let me explain what it actually means when the feds are raising the rates. They aren't raising the rates directly, but rather they are raising the rate at which banks borrow and lend to one another. Now, this isn't the rate that consumers pay, but higher rates for the bank make borrowing more expensive. This eventually affects long-term interest rates like the 10-year treasury yield, in which case long-term mortgage rates follow the same trend. So the feds aren't raising the rates directly, it's more of a ripple effect. Raising those interest rates help to control elevated inflation by slowing down consumption. So now you might be wondering, what is a 10-year treasury? So Forbes.com actually has a pretty good explanation. Let me put that up on your screen. And it says a 10-year treasury is a bond that guarantees interest plus repayment of the borrowed money in a decade. The 10-year treasury is just one of a handful of securities issued by the US government. So what is a 10-year treasury yield? The 10-year treasury yield is the current rate treasury notes would pay investors if they bought them today. So why is the 10-year treasury yield important? Continuing on down this article, the 10-year treasury yield serves as a vital economic benchmark, and it influences many other interest rates. When the 10-year yield goes up, so do mortgage rates and other borrowing rates. When the 10-year yield declines and mortgage rates fall, the housing market strengthens, which in turn has a positive impact on economic growth and economy. So now let's take a look at the 10-year treasury yield. Here on CNBC.com, I've got a chart here that goes all the way back into the 1980s. You can see here in July of 1981, the percentage rate was about 15.82%. And then over the next few decades, it actually has a pretty steady decline, getting to about where we are now. So now let me change it to the 5-year, and we can see a little bit closer on 2020. When the pandemic started setting in, where we can see a pretty sharp decline in these interest rates, and then the mortgage rates followed suit pretty soon after this. So going through mid-2020, July, August timeframe, and then we saw a little bit of an increase going back up to about 1.6%, and then only fluctuating by about 0.5% going into 2021, and then right now 2022, as of today, it sits at 1.96%. And then keeping in mind, so let's go back and look at this steady decline of the 10-year treasury yield. We had a steady decline. So with that said, let's jump over and look at the mortgage interest rate. So let's go back to the 30-year mortgages back in the 1980s. In the 1980s, they were just over 18%. And then after that, we had a steady decline, again, following the same trend of that 10-year treasury yield. Let's put this one on a 5-year scale here. And then going into January of 2020, you can see that the interest rates are starting to decline even more, a little bit more rapidly than they were before. And then into 2021, and where we had rates as low as 2.8-2.7%, depending on what kind of mortgage you're going to get. And then right now the rates are sitting right about 3.5% for a 30-year fixed mortgage. Now it's time for the forecast. So in early 2021, the feds did not anticipate any rate hikes for 2022, but things have since changed. And in order to control inflation, the feds will potentially have to raise rates about 3 or 4 times this year, which is similar to how they did it in 2018. However, a rate hike isn't expected for the next couple of months. Now, there are several experts that have predictions as to where we're going to end up and where these rates are headed. For example, Bank Rate says rates will increase as high as 3.75% before falling back to 3.5%. Joel Kahn from the Mortgage Bankers Association says our forecast is for the 30-year fixed rate to gradually increase over the course of a year, reaching 4% in quarter four 2022. Another year of strong economic growth combined with the Fed's tighter policy stance will put upward pressure on rates. Michael Fratantoni, chief economist for the Mortgage Bankers Association, says rates could reach 4% by the end of 2022. Lauren Yoon, chief economist of the National Association of Realtors, or NAR, forecasts mortgage rates to hit 3.7%. Selma Hepp, who is the deputy chief economist at CoreLogic, predicts rates will be closer to 3.4%. However, on the flip side, there are some other economists that think a little bit differently, coming from Robert Frick, who is the corporate economist for the Navy Federal Credit Union. He says, given mortgage rates are closely tied to the 10-year Treasury yield, and that yield isn't expected to rise much in the next year, if at all, rates could rise slightly, but are likely to remain below 3.5%. Danielle Hale, the chief economist at Realtor.com, expects rates to tick up about a half percentage point to 3.6% in 2022, a jump that's not big enough to disrupt the market. We don't expect to see major shocks, Hale says. Rates have been so low for so long, it might be surprising for some, but 3.6% is a record low in 2019. So my final thoughts on the matter is the fact that we're going to see some rate hikes by the feds. We are going to see increased mortgage interest rates somewhere about 3.75% this year. I'm not sure exactly when it's going to happen. It's probably going to be later, going into Q3 or Q4 of this year. But you have to remember that we are still seeing historically low numbers on these mortgage interest rates, and they're only going to go up just a little bit. So this should not be a discouragement if you're out looking to buy a home or refinance. If it's the right time to do it, then go ahead and do it, especially if you're doing a cash out refi. There's no sense in waiting. Go ahead and do that, because you never actually know what's going to be happening in the future, especially if you wait going into next year and you never pull the trigger on that refinance. And if you would like to discuss how these rising mortgage rates are going to affect your home purchase, go ahead and send me a message and we can discuss some numbers. Otherwise, I'm curious to see what you guys think about these mortgage rates, where they're going to go. Are they going to rise up to 4%, stay around 3.5%, or are they going to stay in the low threes? Leave a comment down below. Let me know what you think. And as always, lastly, if you don't mind, hit that subscribe button. It really does help me build my YouTube channel. Also, once you do that, go ahead and hit that alert bell, so then that way you get notifications when I post more videos like this one. Again, thank you for watching, and we will see you next time.